Hi, my name is Marie Cruz and I'm a Senior Developer Advocate at Grafana Labs. In this beginner-friendly video tutorial, I'll discuss state timeline visualizations in Grafana. By the end of this tutorial, you should know how to configure a state timeline to visualize your data in Grafana. State timeline displays your data in a way that shows state changes over time. You can use a state timeline to monitor the statuses of your servers, applications, or services to know when they are experiencing any issues. You can also use a state timeline to observe operational trends and spot any recurring health issues about your applications. To help you in this tutorial, I'll be using the Grafana test data source, which comes built in with Grafana. The Grafana test data source has different scenarios so you can easily experiment with visualizing the data. With that explanation out of the way, let's get started. First, I'll add a new visualization to a dashboard and select the Grafana test data source. Then, under the visualization dropdown, I can choose the state timeline visualization. A state timeline works best if you have data capturing the various entity states over time. So to work with state timelines, your data must have timestamps, the name of the entities, and their state changes. So the state changes, you can represent that as either a string, numerical, or Boolean values. So for example, I have a table right here that shows how your data should look like to visualize it correctly as a state timeline. To use this data, I'm going to select the CSV content scenario, and then I'm going to convert the example table that you saw to a CSV format. When I hit refresh, you might see an error message saying that the data does not have a time field. The timestamps I've added, they probably been recognized as a string rather than time. So what I'll do is I'm going to add a transformation rule to convert the timestamps column to be of type time. So I'm going to use the convert field type transformation rule for this. Now you should see data being displayed. If you don't see any data, make sure that you are in the correct date range. So you can either search for a quick range or you can also apply the date range manually. Now let's improve how you can visualize this data even more. On the right side, there are different options specific to the state timeline that you can configure depending on your use case. For example, if you don't want to merge the consecutive values, you can toggle this option right here, as well as different formatting options on how you would display the values. If you want to customize how null values, which are gaps that you see in this graph, are visualized, you can choose to connect them so you don't see any gaps, or not if you want to leave them as is. You can also assign colors to different states and make it easier to distinguish any state changes. To do that, I'll click the Add Value Mappings button and set different colors for the up, warning, and down states. I also don't need to set a threshold since I'm not using numerical states for this example, so I'm going to remove the threshold and then we can go ahead and save the changes. And there you have it. In this beginner-friendly video tutorial, I've shown you how you can configure a state timeline to visualize your data in Grafana. Make sure to check out our Grafana documentation if you want to know more about state timelines, which you can find in the video description below. I hope you found this video useful, and if you do, let us know in the comments below. And as always, happy visualizing!